in their case, the ultimate check is we the people, the American people in the electorate. So I think they're just afraid that he's going to be on the ballot. I think he should run again. I've said that many times. But the Democrats are obviously afraid of it. That's why they're engaging in this unconstitutional impeachment process.
Do you think some Republicans are afraid of that process?
Yeah, you have to ask them. But look, 75 million people voted for the president. I think if the election would have been held under the rules that were all changed, I think the Democrats knew ahead of this election that the only way they could beat the president was to change the rules in the run-up to the election, which is what they did. So I think the president's a strong candidate. I think he could win. We'll win again in 2024. But there's obviously some Republicans are called the Lincoln Project. We don't want that. But the vast majority of Republicans across the country, 90-some% of them, wanting to run again. I think it'd be good for the nation if he did.
All right, Congressman Jim Jordan, you expressed your mind, your own way. We appreciate that, Jim Jordan. Get ready for a trial that's totally unnecessary. If that's the battle, we can see it in the sight. It just depends.
Drew, we are taking a look at foreign policy just one day after President Biden was inaugurated. China announced sanctions on 28 Americans, many of whom were part of President Trump's administration. The list includes former Secretary of State Mike Pompeo, former White House advisor Steve Bannon, and former trade advisor.
So I hope Mike has the courage to do what he has to do, for example, Vice President of China. And I hope he doesn't listen to the rhinos and the stupid people that he's listening to. And the crowd goes wild, absolutely wild. Do you think that's
popular? No, I do not. Look, the people who did the harm, they need to be held responsible. But I don't think there was any kind of a language from the president that provoked them or got them or incitement in any form whatsoever. And again, you're singling out the president, but the Speaker of the House has used all kinds of language. But I think could if you use that standard, frankly, what Democrats have said is a lot worse. So look, if we're going to be consistent, we should be consistent in this. The Democrats haven't been. Republicans have condemned all the violence, all the time, all the political violence, both last summer and what happened at the Capitol. But it's not the president's, it wasn't language that the president used that I think in any way caused this. And specifically, the president said, peacefully and patriotically make your voices heard. So how do you impeach a president? Yeah, this is a fundamental question. And if you read the Democrats' brief, and if you read the response of the brief from President Trump's lawyers that I thought was great, how do you impeach a president for constitutionally protected speech? How do you impeach a president for engaging in speech that's protected by the Constitution, the very Constitution we all took an oath to uphold? The Democrats seem to think that doesn't matter, but it certainly does. This is speech that was protected, and it didn't cross the line. And in fact, it was just the opposite when he said, peacefully and patriotically, make your voices heard in our political system. So,
well, you know, Congressman, I read, and I respect you or not, but I did read the entire speech, and that peaceful demonstration comment that you made was a small part of it.